Hi, welcome back. Artificial intelligence or AI is getting infused in every sphere of our life. When we use smartphones to enhance our photos, or when we use Instagram to apply different filters, we are using AI. When we work with, let's say, conversational AI or chatbots, we are using AI. When we interact with things like Alexa, Cortana, or Google Home, or Siri for that matter, we are using AI. So whether we like it or not, we might be using AI in one form or the other. If you are a developer, you might be interested in knowing what does AI has to provide you. In this video, we are going to see how to use GitHub Copilot, which is marketed as an AI-powered pair programmer. My name is Nilesh, and let's get started. Let's start by looking at what is GitHub Copilot. GitHub Copilot is an open AI-based solution which uses OpenAI Codex to suggest code, and it can suggest the entire function or it can suggest a partial function, like single line code, in real time. It helps us as a developer to enhance the coding experience. How do we get started? Let's head over to GitHub Copilot page or portal. And here we have start my trial option. Me being a Microsoft MVP, I have access to GitHub Copilot. If you are eligible, you might be eligible for a GitHub Copilot free trial. Otherwise, there is a sign up fee. Go through this process of the quick start, which talks about the prerequisites and what is required for getting started with GitHub Copilot. It is free to use for some verified students' accounts, teachers, and open source maintainers. And once we sign up for GitHub Copilot, it supports four different IDEs or code editors. We can look at the details of which are the ones which are supported here. Visual Studio, NeoVim, Visual Studio Code or VS Code, and a suite of Jetbrains IDEs like IntelliJ, PyCharm, Rider. All the Jetbrains IDEs, they support GitHub Copilot. So let's say we have already registered for GitHub Copilot. How do we get started or how do we use it? I'm going to use Visual Studio Code, which is my favorite code editor. And in the extensions, when we go to the extension blade here or the extension section, we can find Copilot or GitHub Copilot. Search for GitHub Copilot, and for Visual Studio Code, it's available as the extension. Click on this, and then since I already have it, I have the option of disable or uninstall. But if you are using it for the first time, you will see the install option here. And we can see other details related to how to get started, how to troubleshoot, and other things related to GitHub Copilot. So let's assume that you have GitHub Copilot extension enabled. Let's go and check how we can use it. There is not much configuration to be done. Once the extension is enabled, we will see this icon here for the Copilot. And for the first time, it will ask us to log into GitHub using our GitHub credentials. Once we are authenticated, we can start using GitHub Copilot. So I'm going to use GitHub Copilot in multiple different files or different types of files. First, let's check how to use it to generate single line of code. So I have this function here, or I have this API, which has one function called process, and it's reading some data or it's processing some data from the body of the function or the API call. Currently, it has this code which is putting this application or this thread for sleep for 250 milliseconds. So let's say I want to use a slightly different configuration here for sleeping. So I can start typing. And as I type, you can see that GitHub Copilot is giving me suggestions based on the context of the file. So this is a C# file, and it is giving me a recommendation to see or to generate code using Copilot or using C# as the code. So here, as I type, you can see that it's changing the description of how much time I want to sleep or how much time I want to put the thread to sleep. So let's say I want to put the thread to sleep for 500 milliseconds, which is half a second to simulate the processing. And once I do this, if I'm happy with the recommendation provided by Copilot, I can just press the tab key, and whatever has been recommended, that will get converted, or that will be put as a code, or that will enable the code in my code editor. This is for a single line of code or a couple of lines of code. Let's see how we can generate the whole function. Now, good part about Copilot is it uses a conversational AI or natural language as the way in which we can ask it to generate the code. So let's say I want to log the details of my tech talks object here. So let's write a function to log the tech talk details. That is what I want to write a function for. And you can immediately see that it's generating, or it's recommending a code which takes tech talks as a parameter, or tech talk as a parameter, and log tech talk as a method name. It's creating a private void method, and it's also putting a console.writeline statement there, which uses the tech talk dot tech talk name as the attribute or property to use or to write to the console. So here we can see that the Copilot is able to generate the complete function, and it's also able to infer the attributes of my objects which are used in my program. That was for a C# program or a C# programming language. Let's look at something which is not a programming language or full stack, full scale programming language. I'm going to use Markdown, or I am using Markdown in this particular repository of mine. And I want to use some documentation for my code. I use Markdown for documenting different stages of the application or a different feature. So here we can see that it's also able to recommend me something which is specific to Markdown. I just put the header there, and once I go to the next line, it is also suggesting me a series of lines which will be part of my documentation. So if I am happy again with this, I can just tab, and you can see that it's also able to refer to some of the things that I am using in my code base, like the Docker Compose, aks.yaml. Somewhere in my code or somewhere in my files, there is this file which exists, and it's able to refer to that. So it is context aware, and it knows what exists in my application, and it's able to recommend me something based on that. The third thing I want to check here is a scripting language like PowerShell. I use PowerShell for writing some of the scripts to automate. And let's say I want to delete a resource group. So resource group is again a concept in Azure, Microsoft Azure, and I want to delete one of the resource groups. So the moment I put that command, you can see that there is a recommendation or suggestion given here to have this command azgroupdelete. It's able to take the variable name, resource group name, which is part of this file, and it's inferring, or it's able to derive these names from what exists in my file. So we looked at C#, which is a full-fledged programming language. We looked at Markdown, which is similar to, let's say, HTML file. And there is also scripting, the PowerShell. That was for Visual Studio Code or VS Code. Let's look at the other integration, which is for Java. So I'm going to use IntelliJ as my the integrated development environment or IDE. And once I enable the extension or I install the extension, we can see that there is a GitHub Copilot tab here, which can be used. Now, this works slightly differently in IntelliJ. So if I go to the class level and if I say refresh, it is going to give me some suggestions, or it's going to recommend me some functions based on the type of the class. So I have a controller here for managing types of sessions for, let's say, a tech talk kind of thing or a conference. So based on that, it's generated this code the complete class or the complete function, like based on the conventions or based on the things I'm using in my Java program. So that is about the GitHub Copilot, how it integrates with both Visual Studio Code, VS Code, as well as the IntelliJ. Now there is another feature or another interesting thing which comes with GitHub Copilot. Before I move on to the interesting feature, there are some things which we need to be aware of. The code which is generated here or the code which is recommended is based on the AI model which is built using the different public repositories available on GitHub and other public internet, over the public internet. So the code is not full-fledged 100% correct. It is the responsibility of the developers to make sure that the code which GitHub Copilot recommends is as per the standards. It might not be the latest code. So let's say there is a new library which is released or a new feature in the programming language is released. For example, Java 8 is the current programming language which is used, or Java 8 is the version which is used. And let's say Java 16 or Java 17 comes up. There might be some features in Java 17. Those might not come up immediately because the code for those features is not available publicly. And there are not enough examples for GitHub Copilot to recommend code for that. It will also not be able to identify things like vulnerabilities and if there are any bugs. It is just going to recommend code based on what it has seen in other code bases. So the developer who is using this is fully responsible for making sure that the code is accurate. It is as per the standards of the organization and it is what is really required. So a thorough testing and thorough analysis is required before using this code in production. So please be mindful of that. It improves the efficiency of developers, but the developers have to be a bit more careful when they start using GitHub Copilot in production scenarios. It does help developers to generate code. It does help to improve the productivity of developers, in my opinion. So I hope you found this useful until this point. There is another feature which is available only with Visual Studio Code at this point in time, which I would like to show right now. So along with the GitHub Copilot, there is also another thing which is called as GitHub Copilot Labs. And this is one more extension which is available. And when we enable this extension, what we get is a companion to the GitHub Copilot, which is used for experimentation and to come up with features, different features, which will then later on get integrated with GitHub Copilot. One good feature of this, or one interesting feature of the GitHub Copilot Labs, is it can translate code from one language to another. So I'm going to show you this feature. Let me go back to the C# code and let's see. I have this code which is putting the thread to sleep or whatever is the function, the process function. Now I want to convert this code into a different programming language. Let me go select all this and under the extensions or under this the extensions which are shown, we can go and let me expand this. So let's see how to use the GitHub Copilot Labs feature. It can be used to translate the code. The way we translate the code is we select whatever code we want to use or we want to translate, and we use the language translation feature here. Now under the language translation, you can see that there are various languages which are supported: ABAP, BAT, BitTeX, C, Clojure, COBOL, CoffeeScript, CSS, Dart, so many. So let's say I want to convert this code into Go language. I'm going to go and ask GitHub Copilot to convert this code into Go. And you can see that that process function, which was written initially in C# is now converted into Go. Let's try Java. I click on Ask Copilot to convert this into Java. So you can see here that it is using the Java conversion, and the console.writeLine has been converted into system.out.println for Java. Same way, if you want to use, let's say, JavaScript, we can ask Copilot to convert that function into JavaScript, and it will convert it into the JavaScript syntax. So this is quite handy when we are learning a new programming language, or when we are trying to explore features of a new programming language. Let's say I'm quite familiar with C Sharp and I'm new to Go. I want to understand, or I want to know how to write a particular construct in Go. I can write code in C Sharp, which I'm familiar with, and then ask Copilot to translate that into Go to get the relevant syntax in Go. So I hope you found this useful. GitHub Copilot and the Copilot Labs are quite useful tools, in my opinion, which can help developers to enhance their productivity. They can help developers to do things faster. They can help developers to learn new programming languages. And I'm sure you will find it useful. If you found this video useful, please hit the like button, subscribe to my channel, and let me know in the comments what you feel about Copilot and Copilot Labs. If you are interested in knowing what are the other alternatives, on this channel I did another video for another tool called as Tab9, which is also using AI to generate code. Feel free to have a look at that video. Thanks for watching this.